So when I was looking over what episodes I'm going to look over for this vlog, I just realized most of the episodes are centered around one character, and it's surprisingly Courtney. I'm not kidding, 4 of the 5 episodes stars Courtney as the main character. Getting my personal thoughts on this character, this one is going to be somewhat a bit interesting. No, I don't hate Courtney. She was more of a love-to-hate kind of villain for me when I watched Total Drama. I mean, she was bossy, only cares about herself, and doesn't care about others. And do we need to address Total Drama All-Stars with Sunday Money Sunday? In other words, she is still the number one Total Drama villain. Okay, now that I'm done sharing my opinions, let's look over the episodes. Episode 23, Know-It-All. In this episode, the kids are annoyed at Courtney for bossing them around, so they decide to do a little bet. If she can go through the whole day without bossing anyone, they get to listen to her for a whole week. But if she fails, she has to clean out their cubbies. And let me tell you, it's more than just a pig pen. There's nothing really spectacular about this episode. It's pretty much what you expect. They try multiple ways to make Courtney snap. You have one where they made a disgusting pizza made out of sardines, maple syrup, and expired mayonnaise. Can we put in some jellyfish and grasshoppers while we're at it? They try painting over the outlines using a paint roller because that's worse than that disgusting pizza from earlier. And even have Beth leave the bathroom without washing her hands. The only thing I remember remotely chuckling at is when Courtney looked at herself in the mirror where she knows that they're trying to make her snap and she tries to get a hold of herself. And I love seeing the reactions on Courtney's reflection. But there is one thing that makes this episode not good. It's the annoying side plot on Chad trying to determine if tomatoes and cucumbers are fruit and vegetables. And you can guess where this annoying joke goes from here. It's about as tiresome as that Al Who joke. And every time Chad freaks out whenever he discovers the truth about tomatoes and cucumbers, I just don't care how he feels because it has nothing to do with the episode we're focusing on. But I will admit, I was actually shocked that Dawn actually make a cameo as a scientist. And to be fair, it's actually a good cameo. If this was a prequel to the Redonkulous Race, this is what I imagine what Dawn used to be before he hosts the show as some sort of scientist. Maybe that's how he got his world history from. Not the worst episode, but pretty bland. Episode 24, A Licking Time Bomb. Now this is the episode that is not about Courtney. This time is going to be about Noah and Owen. In this episode, Owen and Noah open a business, which in this case is selling cookies, and people seem to like it. But there is a catch. The secret ingredient behind those cookies is Owen spit. Because somebody likes Snotch Landing, clearly there would be some funny jokes here. Okay, to the episode's credit, it's not as annoyingly disgusting as Snotch Landing. But it's still a generic episode because there's a liar reveal story in this one. And Owen has this bad habit of revealing secrets, and there's even a flashback, one in which he spoils the ending of a movie, which, in my opinion, I think he saved that couple's money. Every time I keep thinking of that flashback, I kind of think that couple was going to see Twilight because they mentioned vampires. Imagine what Owen could do if he spoiled all the bad movies you can think of.
Hey Owen, guess what? I'm going to see Batman v Superman.
Oh yeah, I saw that, where Batman and Superman get along with each other because their mom's names are Martha and Superman dies in the end.
On second thought, maybe I should go see that Happy Time Murders movie.
You mean the puppet movie where the killer was actually the client and the ex-girlfriend?
You know what? Forget it. Maybe I'll go see that live-action Dumbo movie.
He and his mom left the circus.
Forget it. I'm gonna play some video games.
Every once in a while, there are some Korean moments, like when the other Total Drama kids make their own business, like when Izzy birthed the alphabet, and there is a funny scene where Gwen hosts funerals for pets and brothers, and this show has kind of a sick sense of humor. But the one thing that I didn't like is obviously the secret ingredient and this plot hole on how the grown-up discover Owen and Noah's business. I mean, did Chef call them or something? I don't get this, actually. So I guess I'll take this bittersweet episode than a sour one. Episode 25, From Bash to Worse. When I saw this episode, I kind of felt like this was Fresh TV's apology for Sunday Money Sunday because, oddly enough, it's about Courtney and Gwen becoming friends. In this one, Courtney is almost finished on completing her Cookie Scout badge, and she has to make this new friend in order to earn the last badge. And apparently she already made friends with the other Total Drama kids. Okay, that I don't believe, because there is no way she would be friends with Bev because of season 2. But whatever the reason, she has to be friends with Gwen, but she's not the kind that loves happiness and joys and other stuff. This one is mostly pretty good. My only issue I had is the ending, because there's kind of this liar reveal story where Courtney was using Gwen to earn the badge, and Gwen freaked out. And why was she freaked out? I thought she knew that Courtney needed to be friends with Gwen in order to win that badge. It clearly shows when Courtney screamed out that she wants to make new friends. But after that Sora Rush compromise, you already know what the prize is going to be at the end of the episode. I'll give the episode some credit that the two girls do have a good connection, and there are some funny jokes here and there whenever they do hang out with each other. There was a funny joke where Gwen buries her iguana in the sandbox, even though it's alive, but Gwen said it wasn't dead. And there was a creative scenario where they build a new toy based out of random parts, similar to how Sid did in Toy Story. And there's even a funny joke on using worms and what they're good for. And there's even a fantasy on what are they good for. Again, the more they spend time together and have fun, it does feel like they have a good friendship. It makes a lot more sense than a chart, for goodness sake. So I guess I probably consider this as one of the good Total Drama episodes, but only the slightest. Episode 26, Toys Will Be Toys. In this Courtney episode, she tries to be a WeTube star because, get it, YouTube? So she tries to make viral videos on playing with toys, but they don't consider it a big hit despite how many likes she got. People are more interested in Owen and Jude's videos because of how extreme they are. This could be a clever episode, seeing how it's gonna satirize viral videos, but there's nothing really spectacular about this episode, and they don't go deep into the satire on YouTube videos. Every time Courtney records a save video, it always fails, but when Owen and Jude does something extreme, it mostly works, which I was surprised she didn't upload the other videos that she failed miserably, like the dolphins. And actually, one of the reasons why this episode is not a strong satire on YouTube video is actually the ending, where Courtney and Bridget host this extreme video where they're flying through the air alongside Harold, and it looked like they got a million views, only to be banned a few seconds later because of that extreme video. Okay, video 101, if you're planning on making a satire on YouTube videos, make sure it's more accurate to YouTube. When Courtney and Bridget upload that extreme video and got banned for posting videos, there's usually a community guideline before jumping to conclusions. And according to the guidelines, you have 3 chances, 3 strikes, and you're out. That's how it works. And second, if that video was not okay, then how come Owen and Jude are okay on keeping their first video when they send Harold up in the air with a bunch of balloons and almost got hit by an airplane? This WeTube is about as broken as the real YouTube. Actually, that is a good satire, but it still makes no sense. So I guess if you're looking for an episode that satirizes YouTube and viral videos, you might have some, but in my opinion, I'll stick with watching Keyboard Cat videos. Episode 27, All Up In Your Drill. In this episode, they get a special guest, which is a firefighter, and she gives Courtney this firefighter hat for being the class firefighter because she answered all the questions correctly, but she takes the role way too seriously whenever someone mentions fire, and Duncan decides to come up with an elaborate plan to get rid of the firefighter hat so he can wear it and be the class firefighter. There's nothing really much to talk about the episode, but I did get a laugh from the firefighter at the beginning of the episode because she has an energetic personality. And then we know what the outcome's gonna be. Duncan steals the hat, he doesn't know how to be a good firefighter, and he gives the firefighter back to Courtney. They escape from the real fire, and they live happily ever after. But I have to say, did Courtney really have to go that far at the beginning of the episode, where she freaks out whenever someone mentions fire, like from a storybook, or Chef drinking some hot coffee, and spray them with water, and other stuff they mention? She even breaks through a dollhouse because there was no fire exit. It's a toy, for crying out loud. There's Courtney logic and there's Izzy logic. Courtney's pretty much going inside the Izzy logic. The moral of the episode, be sure to learn about fire safety or else Courtney will spray you with water. And that's all the 5 episodes I looked over so far. And let me tell you, the next episodes we're going to look over, they're probably not going to center around one specific character like Courtney. So don't expect any more character arc episodes. Though I wouldn't mind to watch any more episodes that centers around Owen, because he is the best Total Drama character of all time, obviously.